Hi, I'm Craig Omby, and this is another in a continuing series of videos I'm helping my friend Ron Sturgeon produce for his campaign, Make Haltom City Thrive Again. Ron wants to bring all the businesses back to Haltom City and make it easy to start a new business in Haltom City. He's a fierce advocate for small business. He always says their struggle is real. Ron wrote a book on the topic, Keeping the Lights On Downtown in America's Small Cities, the critical role small businesses play in bringing back jobs and prosperity. Please request a free autographed copy if you live in Haltom City. It's received 16 five-star reviews on Amazon. The second edition, with five new chapters, will be out in November of 2022. The book gives many more details about the things we are going to discuss in these videos. You can learn more about Ron's efforts at his Facebook page, Make Haltom City Thrive Again. Ron, I know that Business Alliance submitted a plan to the city of items that they believe the city could do to attract more business. Do you support that plan, and can you tell us more about it?
Well, I'll tell you that it's been a moving target because over a year ago is when we started this initiative, and the list was fairly short. And, of course, the list has grown as we learned more about what the city was and wasn't doing. And as I researched these books, which we're going to talk about in some of the video segments, I learned a lot. I think people want to think that I just wrote this book and I made up this list of what I wanted the city to do. And, of course, that's just not the truth. I researched what other cities had done. There's a lot of information on the internet about what other cities have done to attract small business. They recognized this problem. They realized it was real. They made a plan, and then they executed against a plan. Sometimes they brought in a consultant, whatever. Now, Haltom City's brought in an engineering firm more than once for one of the corridors, and it's never done anything, mostly because the plans revolved around public using public money. And of course, public money's dead. It's gone. Forget it. There is no public money to speak of, certainly not for this kind of endeavor. But yes, we've submitted that list, and it's moved and gotten more expansive, and the city's, of course, seen it some number of times, I'm sure. Yes, I'm a very much a supporter of it.
Okay. So they really haven't given you a solid response in favor of it, though.
Well, they've never given us any response. We even commissioned a third-party study, went out and measured this city against other cities, and some empirical data, types of businesses, types of uses, you know, how their matrices differ from Haltom City's matrices, gave them that, didn't even recognize it, didn't even acknowledge that they had received it. They've never, ever acknowledged the Business Alliance. You know, they've said on numerous occasions that if you don't own property in Haltom City, a residential property, and live in Haltom City, you don't have a seat at the table. What you say is, what you think doesn't matter. And, you know, I know that that we don't want businesses running the city, but that doesn't mean we shouldn't be a stakeholder.
Well, you'd think if you own property in the city that would be a stakeholder.
Well, you'd think if you owned a business in the city or real property in the city or resided in the city, each of those should give you some seat at the table. And again, you know, we could partition the how many seats can be for this and how many seats can be for that, you know, but Haltom City in particular, I genuinely believe and know from working in other cities. I served on a citizen zoning committee in Fort Worth for a number of years. We made recommendations to the council. And so I know that cities do work with the other stakeholders. Haltom City just doesn't.
Y'all submitted through the Business Alliance a report from a third-party consulting firm. Did they acknowledge that?
No. They've never acknowledged anything we submitted.
Ron, can you give us some real details about the plan?
Well, the plan's not a secret. It's printed. It's on the Business Alliance's website. It's been submitted to the city some number of times. But let's make sure that we move through those. Let's do some videos on them. It's going to take more than one video, but need to encourage everybody that's watching to know that there's a number of videos out there. You can hear the whole plan, everything that's been proposed. And because the citizens need to understand, you know, what the Business Alliance is really wanting. And in most cases, I don't think it's against the residents' interest. I just don't.
These videos are to help voters so they can make an informed choice in the next election about who's going to lead and bring solutions for the city. Thanks for watching, and I encourage you to watch the other videos posted, and most importantly, to make sure you vote in the next election as we strive to bring back prosperity in Haltom City's declining areas and corridors in the central and south parts of the city. We need pro-business candidates to serve on the City Council. If you are interested in helping or serving, reach out to Ron for more information.